Workplace investigators were on the scene tonight at a Claremont fabrication plant where a man was crushed and sustained fatal injuries this afternoon. Police say a worker at Canam Steel was helping to load a large steel span onto a trailer when he was pinned underneath the trailer's wheels. Our Adam Sexton is live tonight in Claremont, where the industrial accident remains under investigation. Adam?
Well, Tiffany, the chief of police says Can-Am has a solid safety record here in Claremont, but today a man working here died, and now investigators are trying to determine how and why that happened.
The Can-Am plant on River Road in Claremont fabricates the steel girders and arches used to make large bridges. Friday afternoon, police say workers were in the process of loading an arch for transport when one of those workers became pinned under the wheels of a trailer. The 911 call drew fire, paramedics, and police.
Fire, with the assistance of a Golden Cross ambulance, was able to free this individual from underneath the trailer, and he was immediately transported to Valley Regional Hospital.
First responders say the man sustained severe crush injuries and did not survive.
Obviously, all life-saving efforts were underway, but unfortunately, the individual did succumb to his injuries.
The New Hampshire Medical Examiner's Office and the Occupational Safety and Health Administration are now handling the investigation. The accident site itself remains intact within the confines of the Can-Am property, with the truck involved cordoned off by yellow tape. Police say the arch that was being loaded on the trailer is actually one of the smaller fabricated pieces made at this facility. Nonetheless, its weight, and even the weight of the trailer designed to carry it, is significant. For now, the name of the accident victim is being withheld while investigators notify his family.
Now, it isn't clear where this particular arch involved in the accident is eventually going to be headed, but it's possible, looking at the Structural Bridges website, it's going to end up in the bridge being built over the Pawtucket River in Rhode Island. Reporting live in Claremont tonight, Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.